A very, very warm welcome to the fourth session of SprintX for ICSE 10th. I am Ankana, your master teacher for social sciences at Vedantu. Hoping all my dear bachas are doing absolutely fine and amazing. So guys, let's get started. We have finally finished the international movement. Now we're going to get started with the second part, which is the mass phase of the national movement right from 1915 till 1947. And under this, what are we going to cover? We're going to talk about Mahatma Gandhi and the national movement, the Quit India movement, Forward Bloc and the INA, and of course, independence and the partition of India. So stay tuned. This is going to be a super fun session. Let's get started. But before that, let's have a quick look at the schedule for Sprint. So bacha, this is your schedule for physics with Anoop sir, chemistry with Anubha ma'am, maths with Gopal sir, biology with Ambika ma'am, social science with me, and English with Shweta ma'am. Now guys, that you have all the information and you are super excited for the session or series, I must say, do not forget to hit the like button. Keep those likes coming in. Likes bahut kam pade yaar, likes bahut kam aa rahe videos pe. Come on, keep those likes coming in. Do not forget to tell me in the comment section if you're enjoying the sessions or not. Make sure that you're subscribed to the channel, because as you saw, every day for the entire month of February, we are going to have one or the other session for Sprint for all across all subjects. So make sure to subscribe to the channel so that you do not miss on any of the sessions. And of course, keep sharing the video with your friends. Let them also enjoy, right? Okay, so now let's move on forward. Let me quickly check the focus of the camera. We'll start with the discussion of the homework question given in the last session, which was, in which newspaper house did Bipin Chandra Pal work as journalist? Which of the correct answer is D, all of the above. Bengal Public Opinion, The Tribune, or New India, all of this is where he had worked as a journalist. Now, I quickly want to take a moment and thank you guys. I mean, like all of you. Because I just wanted to, and I've been in the zone of giving this note of thanks and gratitude to everyone, because I can't thank you guys enough how happy it makes me to read these comments. And this is how it keeps me going and super excited for all the sessions. And you guys are like, ma'am, how do you work so hard? How do you work so, for all the teachers for that matter, that how do you guys work so hard? How you guys are working so much, this and that, guys. It's because of all of this love that we're receiving. And thank you so much, Shivani Jha, eagerly waiting for the session. Ayush Yadav, damn excited for the session. Banita Sagar, eagerly waiting for this most awaited session. Thank you, ma'am. Naman Sharma, super duper excited for Anku ma'am's masterclass. So sweet of you guys. And not just these children, all the children out there who have ever made an effort of writing the comment. Thank you so much, everyone. It's your love, your encouragement, acknowledgement that keeps us going inspired and motivated and so consistent and on the path. So let's get started in a little dose of inspiration and motivation for you guys as well. Success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in, day out. I completely agree with this. I have to shred all of this fat, okay? And if I tomorrow just wake up and decide that, hey, I have to shed this, and I diet and work out, no matter how intensively, I will not lose it in a week. I have to every day make efforts to eat healthy, to walk, to do some physical exercise, to burn out all that calories that I'm eating through all that unhealthy junk food. And only then I can stop that, right? Only then I'll be in a good shape, I'll be healthy, I'll be fit. If one day I just want to do it, I will not attain the success. The same thing goes for you. If you want to attain success, if you want to be at a particular point, some target, some goal that you want to achieve, you have to keep going every day. Let's say you're not feeling like doing it today, but don't put a stop to it completely, okay? If you decided on a regular basis to learn for like 6 hours, study for 6 hours, give 1 hour, give 2 hours, okay? At least let's say this phase goes on for a week completely, not one day. You will not end up losing 6 hours every day. You would at least have covered like 2 hours for 7 days, 14 hours. You're ahead of where you would have been if you wouldn't have continued. So just make sure that if you want to attain success, you have to keep going. It's a consistent process. You have to keep churning the wheel. So let's get started and make our very first step towards the success. With this session, the very first question, which is a 2-marker question, and bacha, normally in exam, you would take 3 to 4 minutes to answer this question. We're going to find it up in 2 minutes. Why did Mahatma Gandhi started his historic march to Dandi? Bacha, we know Dandi March was done to break the salt law. What was the salt law? So Britishers had monopoly. Okay, they had said that only they will produce and sell salt. On top of that, they used to impose tax, salt and sugar both. Now, salt and sugar is something which is very, very basic. It is a necessity of, for everyone, irrespective whether it is rich, poor, man, woman, whatever, whoever, forward caste, backward caste, which religion, nothing matters. Everyone requires salt and sugar. Now, this showed the real picture of their oppressiveness of the Britishers, that what they were doing, because they were imposing tax on such a necessary thing, on such a basic thing that is required for survival, salt and sugar. So that is what Mahatma Gandhi did. He actually wrote a letter. Okay, he wrote a letter to the Viceroy Lord Irwin, and he said actually 11, conditions over there. He had said 11 conditions, which was basically to kind of cater to every part of group of the society, every strata of the society, so that no one would feel left out. One out of these conditions was to actually abolish the salt law, to abolish the salt tax, which Lord Irwin was a bit reluctant about. And he had even warned him that if you do not do this, we are going to go complete into civil disobedience movement. So he did not listen, obviously. So he marched to Dandi and he started the civil disobedience movement with the historic march and breaking of the salt law. So according to salt law, the British government had the monopoly to manufacture and sell salt, which means, what do you mean by monopoly, guys? Only Britishers could do. Only Britishers could do this. No Indians were allowed. Okay, so he said that nahin, aise nahin chalega, this is not how it's gonna work. Okay, so he had selected the to attack salt laws because the salt tax affected all sections of society, especially the poor. So when he thought that he has to actually get started with a movement like CDM, civil disobedience movement, he had to get started in a way where he was actually, uniting everyone. So he saw salt as that symbol which would unite everyone together, which would bring everyone together, and everyone would relate to this movement. Okay? So this is your 2-marker question. You have to make sure that you're writing at least 2 distinct points or at least an answer in 30 to 40 words. You can go up to 50 words, but 30 to 40 words should be fine. Next, name any 2 leaders of the Khilafat movement. Bacha, what was Khilafat movement? Sabse pehle we have to understand, we know that Ottoman Empire, right? It was against the British Empire. Okay, they were fighting in the World War. After World War, basically the Ottoman Empire declined. Okay, Greek and everyone got independence from the Ottoman Empire. And here sat the chief of Islam, who was the Khalifa or the Caliph. Okay. Khalifa or the Caliph. Now he was the head of Islam, okay, religion. Now when Ottoman Empire had declined, it was said that he would be revoked from his powers and his title will be taken away. Basically, he will not be there in the position that he was. Now this seemed like a threat to the whole Islamic community across the world. Everyone was threatened. So everyone started going against Britishers, especially because they were fighting against the Ottoman Empire, especially in India. So whole movement started called the Khilafat movement. So group of Muslims got together to oppose this. And it was actually led by the Ali brothers. Okay. Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali. So these 2 names is what you have to mention. Bacha, I have given you the name over here. You can just write that Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali were the leaders of the Khilafat movement. Eventually, they did go and collaborate under the Satyagraha with Gandhiji as well. So we know that they worked together with the NCM and all of that. So we have discussed this pretty much, but these 2 names is what you have to write. I would suggest you can also kind of describe and talk about what had really happened because of which the Khilafat movement had started. So you can first talk about who the leaders were, and in short, in a sentence, you can describe that this movement started against the Britishers in India because they were against the Ottoman Empire, which in the war, which was declined, and the Islamic the Islamic head, Caliph, was now going to lose all his powers, etc. So with this, we have covered the second question. Moving on to the third question. State any two causes that led to the civil disobedience movement in 1930. There were so many causes. First of all, non-cooperation movement had failed. So it had paved way for CDM already. But there were so many things that were not happening. First of all, salt tax was not abolished, right? Lord Irwin had promised a lot of things, but he had not really followed his word. Okay, he had even invited for round table conference. The leaders, but it was just you could say time wastage, and they had promised that they would not do anything to anyone, but they had started arresting the nationalists. By the time Gandhiji came back, he felt like it was all a lie. So it was all of this combined. You can write any two reasons. Okay, so the passing of complete independence or Purna Swaraj resolution at Lahore session of the Congress was one major reason. They were completely not ready that we have to not obey them and we have to throw them out of the country. And so second, of course, rejection of Gandhi's 11 point program, which was the 11 conditions. I told you, right, that he had written a letter with 11 conditions which was presented in front of the Viceroy, and he was expected to accept it, which he was pretty reluctant to, and he had warned him already that if you do not abolish the salt tax, we will do this, and they did this. They went ahead with the CDM. So this was another mass movement, right? CDM was another mass movement that was launched to bring the whole nation together and give a united front, strong united front to the Britishers. Okay, now I have something very interesting for you, which is the Vedanta Pro subscription. So guys, I actually want to talk about this because I know a lot of you have heard this, but probably you've not been able to find your way out. Today I will show you how to find your way out. So let me just quickly take you through. First of all, let you know what does this offer, why are we even suggesting that you should go ahead with it, is that it has unlimited live classes, guys. You don't have to wait for the sessions to be live so that you could interact with the teachers and have more fun, because all the sessions under the subscription is actually live. And you don't even have to wait for mentees, because you get to have live quizzes, which is going to give you a quick understanding throughout your sessions, is going to check your understanding throughout the sessions through amazing quizzes, which is also giving you a lot of exposure, because it is giving you an opportunity to compete with the students throughout the world. Aap puri duniya ke students ke saath compete kar rahe ho. That is super, super amazing. At the same time, just in case if you fail, okay, to attend the live session, it's unlimited, right? Naturally, you will fail, or probably the time didn't suit you, but there's also a catch. If just in case the time is not suitable for you, you can always choose a schedule which is favorable for you. Coming back to the point, let's say that you have you're going for replays. Replays are always very boring, and you feel like, yaar, kya hai? I wanted to attend the live session. Now it's going to be boring, but it'll not be boring anymore because the quizzes are going to be live even in the replays. And you will get to see your name if you've played really fast and answered all the questions right on the leaderboard, just like the live session. So you're going to get the feel of a live session even in replays. Now, handwritten notes of master teachers with amazing content, which you can download unsaid. And all your doubts, bacha, most of it will be solved. And I will show you, I will prove this to you how. And every session is followed up with an assignment. And you also get tests very frequently to keep a check on your understanding, to give you not just a check back, but actually to help you learn from assessment, okay? Not to learn for assessment. So you get to learn from assessment through this whole process. That's the best part. And if you feel that, no, this is something that I'm lacking knowledge in, how do I revise this? The session has already happened. You get micro sessions. Anything that you feel you need more assistance in, you keep on having all these micro sessions, which are going to be absolutely free for you. You can just go and attend a chapter, which is, in particular being taught to the students of your grade, whatever syllabus or whatever content you want to learn. At the same time, there's so many crash courses that we have got started with, especially to revise in the end, the entire syllabus that you have. All of this is going to be entirely free for you, which is going to make less a lot more. So guys, the link is given in the description box. It is also pinned in the comment section. AKEPRO is the code, and I will show you how to go there. And if you actually see and you apply the code, okay, the moment you apply the code, the price is going to come only to 11 rupees per session. You know where to go. And if you don't, let me quickly take you. There's one more way to do it. Okay, so here it is. Amazing. So this is suppose my session. Now let me show you the entire screen. Let's say this is my session, okay? And I go scroll down here. See, this is the description box, okay? So bacha, description box mein when you go over here, you have to scroll down and this is the link, okay? This is the link to the app and this is the link to the pro discount, pro subscription. So you go here and you open this. And when you go here and open this and it's taking some time, you get to choose your grade. So select your grade and select your board. So I want ICSE 2021. Now all the details you can find right over here. Everything that you want to know, the teachers, who all are teaching, if you have any, you want to talk about the results, frequently asked questions, all the details are right over here and here is your plan. Now you might be thinking, ma'am, it is 2699. You said it's going to be 2159. You proceed to pay. Don't worry. Okay. Now I have proceeded to pay. Remember guys, I gave you a coupon code. You just have to apply this code AKEPRO. And if you see the moment I apply it, the price is going to change to 2159 as I have told you over here, right? See, 2159. So 2159 is the price that you just have to pay and then you just go ahead and your plan will start. That's the super amazing part of it. And as I was telling you, that if you actually want to see this is how your replays will look like. So let's say if you open your tab, this is how it will look like. My internet all of a sudden has got really slow. Come on, buddy, don't embarrass me. Okay guys, meanwhile, while this tab opens, I also want you to know that there's also one more way. You can also go on vdnt.in/yt pro. The moment you go on this link, this will directly lead you to this page where you can get the subscription. So this is another way where you can get it from, okay? And then if you actually go, see, this is your schedule, how it will look like. This is how exactly the students page will look like. These are your sessions. These are upcoming and this is for past. So let's say if I want to go ahead and open one of the sessions, okay? Let's say this. So I'll go ahead with the replay. So this is how you can go ahead for your replay if it's not a live session. And you can go ahead with try alternative replay for both live quizzes and everything. And this is the whole stats. And if you actually see, these are the number of quizzes that have happened. So around 15 questions were asked through this session. And this is, so many hotspots, quizzes, all of this is what has happened. And doubt station, if you look at, 15 doubts were asked and 14 out of those 15 doubts were actually solved. So we are not kidding when we are saying that all your doubts will be answered. Most of your doubts always gets answered just at 11 rupees for each, session. And all that you're getting for this amount is super amazing. Don't you agree? So guys, this is what you have to do. The link is given in the description box, as I told you. You can also go on, as I told you, vdnt.in/ytpro. Just type this and you will directly be directed to the page. Don't forget to apply this code. Whenever you apply this code, you'll get extra 20% off. So just start enjoying. Happy learning, people. Hope to see you on the live platform in the live sessions. If not, we'll continue learning here. Let's get started. Explain briefly the reason for the suspension of non-cooperation movement by Gandhi in 1933. Bacha, it's a 3-marker question. It can also come for 4 marks. You have multiple points for this. Ideally, it will take 4 to 5 minutes, but we'll solve it in 3 minutes. There were multiple reasons, okay? There were multiple reasons. The very first thing is that the citizens of India, okay, the nation was actually not ready for a mass movement. Not ready for a mass movement. Why? Because not everyone had the same expectations out of the movement. So there was basically a whole range of expectations from this movement. Different people had different expectations. And that is where there was a problem, because there was a mismatch. And to get so many people on the same page was a little difficult, which we were a little more well prepared for during the CDM, Civil Disobedience Movement. The non-cooperation movement was majorly withdrawn because of the Chauri Chaura incident, as you guys know. Okay, so you definitely have to talk about this event. But moreover, we know that the whole idea of non-cooperation movement was not to cooperate with the Britishers, but this was going to be a non violent movement, right? There was no violence that was going to be involved in this movement. But this is something that was not being followed. And in the name of Gandhiji, a lot of people had started doing a lot of other things. So this is a major, major factor, right? Because Satyagraha was the fight of and for truth, right? And he said that you do not need, you do not require force. Who said this? Gandhiji said this, right? He said, you do not require force. If you are truthful, your oppressor will realize this automatically, and you don't have to use a mode of violence. But this is what people were not understanding. So the movement was suspended by Gandhiji due to the ugly incident which took in Chauri Chaura village of Uttar Pradesh, where 22 policemen were burnt alive by a mob. Gandhiji took a serious view of the incident. He felt that the nationalist workers had not yet properly understood the philosophy of non-violence, which means they were not ready and prepared for such a mass movement, because not everyone was on the same page, not everyone had the same understanding. Non-violence was creed to Gandhiji, who could hardly tolerate that his followers should indulge in violence. This is something he never ever wanted. So he took the step of suspending the movement. In 1922, there was a revolution in Turkey. Turkey became a republic. So after the revolution, the movement lost its importance. So all of this was happening. Moving on to the next question. What were the implications of the Rowlatt Act? Okay. So again, bacha, this is a 3-marker question. First of all, in such a question, always describe this the acts that have been asked. So it was an act passed in 1919. Aapko 4 se 5 minute lagega. You may take 4 to 5 minutes in your exam. We're going to wind it up within 3 to 4 minutes, less than that. Okay. So we have to at least write 3 points. The very first thing has to be introduction. Always, always introduce the act that has been mentioned in short. If you want to explain, if you feel it's relevant, explain further. Now, what was this Rowlatt Act? It basically gave immense power to the authority, right? So immense. Okay. Now it was going to allow the exploitation of power even more. See, enormous power is something that the authority, British authority, already had. But this act further added on to it. Why? Because they could now arrest anyone for 2 years. They could put anyone, imprison anyone for 2 years without any trial. Without trial. So this was the problem with the act. And that is why people were so, so angry against it. So they had now started coming for, silent protests on the roads. Jallianwala Bagh was actually an implication of the Rowlatt Act only. Okay, all of these incidents is what started happening. And it also led to a lot of protests. Okay, so arrest of a person without a warrant. In trial in seclusion, trial in seclusion, not other people would be there to hear, to listen to the trial, and restrictions on movement of individuals, suspension of rights of habeas corpus. What is habeas corpus? We have actually done this under the power of, a writs of Supreme Court. So habeas corpus, bacha, was suspended. There was no right to trial given to people. So these were few drawbacks of this, and it ultimately resulted in protest, Jallianwala Bagh incident. So always remember, see, before talking about this, actually properly describe the act. As I told you, introduce the act properly and then say what were the conditions under it. Then it was passed in 1990. It was going to give enormous power and the free right hands to the British authority, which they already had. They already had immense power, but now they were going to exploit it even more because of the following reasons. Okay. Moving on to the next question, question number 6. What did the Congress consented to the Gandhi-Irwin Pact? Okay, what did the Congress consented to the Gandhi-Irwin Pact? It's a 3-marker question. 3 number ka sawal hai, 3 to 4 minutes. To suspend the civil disobedience movement, to participate in the second session of the roundtable conference, not to press for investigation into police excesses. Okay, basically what happened was that they said that fine, all of these things is happening, we will honor it if all of these conditions are obeyed. That's the thing, Bacha. This was not actually obeyed, and that's why they resumed with the civil disobedience movement for the second time. Because whatever Britishers said, they actually betrayed the people. They did not really follow those words. Okay, moving on to the next question. State any four impacts of the non-cooperation movement. What were the impacts of non-cooperation movement? We know that different stages, different places, the impacts were different. Middle class had different expectations. Tribals, peasants had different expectations. Plantation workers had different expectations. So there were multiple impacts in different places, right? So the national movement became a mass movement as different sections of India society participated in it. Also had different expectations. Do write this, okay? Different expectations. The movement gave rise to the sentiments of nationalism on a wider scale. When thousands of people worked together shoulder to shoulder and resisted the British for months, the national movement naturally became quite wider in its scope. It further united the people and brought them together. Okay, so they came together finally. And, you know, it was no longer limited to only few educated urban people, which was how it started. Instilled confidence among the people and generated a desire for freedom. They knew what they wanted. Now they had started asking for freedom. They knew that freedom was not something that they needed to beg for. It was their right. Okay, and it generated a desire for freedom and inspired people to challenge the colonial rule. The Congress became a revolutionary movement. They, we know, were very, very active. So it became the organizer, leader of masses in their national struggle. The Congress decided to use the weapons of satyagraha and non-cooperation on a wider scale. Fostered Hindu-Muslim unity. We know, bacha, non-cooperation movement and Khilafat movement went hand in hand. That is how they started working together under satyagraha. So this was the first major movement in which Hindus and Muslims participated as one. The scenes of fraternity, friendly relations were witnessed all over the country. Bacha, this was a four marker question. That is why we have made sure to mention at least four distinctive points. You have to make sure that your answer goes somewhere around 120 words. Okay. Next question. Write the points of the programs of the non-cooperation movements. Bacha, picketing, boycotting, making in India, all of these things, what were the points, you know, different things that we were taking under non-cooperation. We were making sure of manufacturing our own clothes. All of these things is what was happening, okay? Now, also, people wanted to be in the government, under the Government Act of India, they wanted to be into the government institutions, but they also boycotted the election. So they boycotted a lot of things. So boycott of government, schools, colleges, courts, anything which was for British, okay, Britishers. Boycott foreign goods, which was manufactured by them. Boycott the elections to be held for the councils as suggested by the reforms of 1919. Resignation, Government Act of India, okay, resignation from nominated seats in local bodies. Surrender of titles and honorary offices, refusal to attend government functions. Swadeshi programs, make everything in India. Popularization of Swadeshi and Khadi by reviving hand spinning and hand weaving. Establishment of national schools and colleges, private arbitration courts known as panchayats all over India. Development of unity between Hindus and Muslims. Removal of untouchability and other measures of Harijan welfare. Emancipation, which is freedom, and upliftment of women. All of these were factors. So with this session, we have finished the first part, which is Mahatma Gandhi and the national movement, the nationalism movement, the movement of nationalism, the wave of nationalism that he brought with himself. Bacha, with this, we come to our homework question. What was the date of Jallianwala Bagh tragedy? April 30, 1919, April 26, 1929, April 15, 1947, or August 15, 1947. Now, let's have a quick look at the schedule. But your previous session was of the Indian National Movement, which came yesterday at 9 p.m. Today, at 6 p.m., we have come with mass phase of the National Movement. Tomorrow, and again at 9 p.m., we're going to have another session of mass phase of National Movement, part 2. So stay tuned and we are going to rock. We have seen what Vedantu Pro subscription can do for us. So go ahead and take a part in this. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel, but just stay tuned, stay subscribed. Do not forget to like the video and share the video with your friends. Do tell me in the comment section how did you like the video, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Till then, stay home, stay safe, take good care of yourself. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.